Hello friends, welcome to my videos. So in this video we are gonna walk through the process of how to create an Express Entry profile for your Canada immigration. Before I proceed further, if you have not already subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe, because I regularly upload videos and I am open to all your questions, suggestions, feedbacks and anything else that you want to ask. And also write down what exactly would you like to watch in the future videos, so that I can accommodate your request in my future videos list. Alright guys, so let's proceed. So for the first screen you see here, I have opened a Google search page. There I simply put the text Express Entry Profile Create. So I reached here. Let's start with this. So here you see that some information is given here. Now let's go back. This is not what we are looking for. All right, let's go here. The first one, online form. So here you have this link. Create your Express Entry profile. So before you go for this, you need to check if you are eligible, so that it takes you to fill out an Express Entry profile. So click here. All right, so I'm checking the eligibility. So I'm going to create based on a dummy profile. I mean, let's say a guy who is in India, is a graduate, age is let's say 27, has scored 7 in all 4 sections of IELTS, and he has 5 years of foreign work experience. All right, let's see. So let's say Ontario, in which territory you wanna stay. Next, you need to submit language test from program. Which language test did you take for your first official language? Let's say IELTS, as I said. Which date? So let's say he took this test recently in the month of April 1st. Okay, now it is asking for the scores in all the 4 sections. Let's go for it. Let's assume that the guy scored 7 in all 4 sections. Do you have other language tests? Assume no, he does not have none. In last 3 years, how many years of skilled work experience do you have in Canada? So suppose he has no Canadian experience. So it's no, but it's in your case. Like it could be, if you have been working in Canada, you can put 1 year or more or less than whatever is applicable in your case. If you do not have any Canadian work experience, please choose none of the above for this section. Yeah, if you have worked in Canada, you need to pick up based on your NOC code where you have worked. Skill level A, B or 0, because these 3 skill level categories are eligible for Express Entry. So select which one of these actually is applicable for you and click at none of these above. Next. In last 10 years, how many years of skilled work experience do you have? It must be in continuous, paid, full time and in only one occupation. Alright. So let's say, as I said, assume that guy has 5 years. So I select 4 to 5. In last 5 years, do you have at least 2 years of experience in one of these types of jobs, skilled trades, industrial electrical maintenance, chef, butcher, baker, supervisor, technical jobs in natural resource, agriculture, products, nose. As I assume that the guy is doing an IT job. So these things are not applicable. What happened? I just said none. Now let's go to next. Maybe I clicked on next. How much money you'll bring to Canada? So let's say this guy has like prior saving or whatever, he has around $20,000. So I select this. How many family members do you have? Let's say 1. Do you have a valid job offer in Canada? No.
What is your date of birth? So let's assume the guy was born on, I said 27 years, right? So let's say 6, 94, all right. 1st January 1994. What is the higher level of education for you? Which you have? Okay, so this is for your ECA if you don't have any Canadian education. So let's say he has done his ECA and it is considered equivalent to bachelor degree or 3 or more programs at a university or trade. Okay, fine. Let's go to the next page. Now check what is applicable. I have studied full time in Canada for 2 years or more. I have at least 2 years of work experience in Canada. No. I have a relative in Canada who is 18 years of age or older, citizen permanent in Canada, and is my parent, child, grandparent, grandchild, sibling, aunt, uncle, niece or nephew. Now, for this video, I assume that this guy has a sister who is living in Canada, but many of the cases, it's going to be none of the above. All right, this is based on your individual case. Let's say the guy is not married. Okay. So this is the personal reference code that you need to apply, that I was talking in the step one. All right. And it says that you appear to be eligible for express entry. So you can click on exit questionnaire. Now we came out again, I'll search for that. So I came back to the first page where I have this link. Now you have two options. This option one is for people, those who are in Canada and use these financial institutions to log in. Otherwise, if you're not in Canada, you can go for continue to GCK. You need to create a GCK account. So if this is the first time, click on sign up. Click yes. You need to create a username. So I'm going to create a username. Continue. Okay, it was accepted. Password. Okay, after you set your password, the next step is to select your recovery questions. Where did I meet my first significant? I'll just put random values, let's say New York. But remember, my memorable person, recovery answer, person, mommy, tell him, mom. My memorable date. Okay, difficult to answer, but 2001. It's a new millennium. Funny, but okay, continue. GCK complete. I accept. Okay, now from this day, like you created the GCK login information, make sure you protect it, you place it safe, and from here you're gonna start. So I'm gonna create a profile, let's say for a guy name whose name is a very common Indian name, or let's Ashish Kumar, a very simple name, Ashish Kumar. I have created a email address for this. English, continue. Security question one and answer. Okay. My height, 6 feet. then my favorite movie. This is not my favorite movie, this is for the, but I like this movie. Taken. My favorite food, biryani. My favorite game, IGI. Of course, these are not my valid answers, just for sample, so don't assume. What are the errors? The question must contain at least 10 characters. My height is what? I think others should be fine. Yes. Alright. So here you have reached the page where you can proceed. Alright. Now apply to vehicle proceed. You can see that this first table shows where you can see the applications that you have submitted, and also you can link an any existing application that you have submitted on paper, and you can link it over here. And if you start an application and not have completed, you can click here. You can find that here. So let's start an application. So personal reference code that we created there. Okay, see, some information is already captured. Kumar, first name Ashish, male, next. What is your marital? So let's say never married, single. Okay, so now we have reached the stage where it is showing the information. Let's fill up. First is personal details. Next. Okay, country of birth, let's say India. City of birth, New Delhi. Next. Married, never married, okay. Passport nationality, yes. ID number, okay. I need to put a dummy number. Issue, let's say India. When was passport issued? Let's say it was issued in 2018 January 1st, 17 1st. And it will go up to 2028. And click on next. Immigration is has applied to IRCC before. So I assume it's the first application. No, but if you have applied, you need to select yes. Country of citizenship. I assume he has only one citizenship, India, but if you have dual or more, just click on insert row and add. Country of residence, India. Next. How many family members does Kumar, this include Ashish Kumar, a spouse or partner, dependent children, other dependent children? So we assume that he is not married, so no question of spouse, he is alone. How much money? So I assume 20,000. Next. Select yes. We assume that his sister, brother is living. And let's say living in Ontario. Click on save and exit. Now you reach back on this table. You see personal details are over. Contact details. Language of correspondence, English. Next. email address. So I'm gonna use the same one that I have created for this purpose. Okay, this is also complete. Study and languages. Yes, he has completed, finished high school or any higher education. Yeah, field of study, let's say he has done in IT. So what options we have? Computer. Okay, since years, and he completed let's say in 2013, so he started in 2009 and he completed in 2013. No, 2013 May. Again, be very careful when you fill these fields for you. This was a full time. Country of study, let's say he studied in India. Let's say he studied in New Delhi. Let's say he studied in New Delhi IT College. This is a dummy name. Level, bachelor's. Diploma for this period of Canadian degree diploma, no. Then education, yes. ECA, let's say he got this ECA from WES. And when it was issued, let's say he got it issued in this year, January. And let's say January 15, he got it. ECA certificate number, I don't know the format, but I'll try to create something. ECA 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Level of an education, what they assess to, let's say bachelor. Save and add. Next. Official language. Communicate in English or French? Yes, English. Assessment, yes. So this is picked up. Make sure if you're going for explanatory, make sure you do the test in general training. Date you have results, and date you appear for the exam, and date results. So IELTS results come in 13 days. Oh, we are yet to reach April 13, but let's see if it accepts. 13. Form. Okay, form number. IELTS 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Save and exit. Oh yeah, because it's a future date. So I'm gonna do one thing. I'm just gonna play a bit. March, let's say 6. Then March, let's say 19. I hope this accepts now. Are there any other error? Need to go previous and then come back. Next. Okay. March 19. Okay, so we completed study and language section as well. Application details. So in which province you would be living to, it's up to you, but I would select all, and I will authorize them to collect the information. Next. Has I received a nomination? Let's say no. Save and exit. Representative. So it's up to you. I don't want any representative because I have done all my process on my own. It's up to you. Okay. Work history. Let's say So here you need to nominate your NOC. So I just selected one. So because this is not falling in this trade section, I'll select the day he was graduated. So it was 2013 May. Next. Certificate of qualification, no. Next. Have a job offer, I assume no. Work history, have any work history, yes. So I assumed he started working for, let's say, from 2014 January. And if you select this is my current job, this will go up. Hours per week, let's say he worked 40 hours a week. So for full time, you need to work 30 hours per week. And again, it's asking for the NOC code. So I'll select the same. Job title, I select analyst programmer. Employment, employer company name. If you are self-employed, click here. I say IT Delhi. Country, territory, India, city, town, New Delhi. Save and add. So I assume this guy has worked for only one employer. That's why I quit. Okay, in progress. I should have clicked on next. No worries. Next. 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 Oh, I did not save it. Work history, no problem. Assume 2014 Jan. And still 40 hours a week. 2174 NOC code. Job title analyst programmer, employer company name IT Delhi, country territory oh wait, it's already here, so it was saved. Only thing I need to click on next. Alright. The following questions are about your education versus recognition Canada. IRCC will only use this information for research performance measurement or evaluation purposes and not to make a decision about your profile application. Your answers are important and will help improving employment services. Would you answer? Okay, no problem. I'll answer. Have you looked for a job in Canada in your primary occupation? Yes, I have done some research to find a job. Have you checked to see if your education or work in your profession would be accepted in Canada? Yes. With whom did you check, Mark? Or let's say employer, work related professional organization. Okay. My trade is not regulated because it's an IT, it does not require license or certification. So that's it. Save and exit. Alright, so you have completed all sections. You can click on continue. Here you need to do electronic signature. I agree. You need to put your name as your signature and the question that you selected. Sign it. You must select I agree. Oh, I miss select. Oh, have to select this. I agree. Next. Incorrect response. Thought this was my answer. Okay, so now I have reached the next page. Here you need to click on transmit. So that's it, you have submitted your profile. Now you can click on exit questionnaire. So you can see that this has been submitted here. So that's how it works. Right now it is being processed. And then if anything happens, it will. I'll delete this profile because my purpose was just to show you, and that's why I selected the score up to the extent that it does not draw any invitation. So that's how it works. So I hope you like this video. Make sure you give it a like and comment. And if you have any concern, any question, anything that you want to ask, please go ahead and ask. Thank you.